Multimodal AI, as I can imagine it this decade, will significantly disrupt the Hollywood industry. This is because when I first saw DALL-E and its ability to generate such impressive images from nothing, just with a text description, I was reminded of the cartoon that kickstarted Disney itself, called Steamboat Willie, released in 1928. Unfortunately, because Big Mouse Incorporated has fought to extend the copyright on this one, I can't show it to you here on YouTube, but the point I'm making is that after the release of DALL-E, I think the tech industry will experience its own Mickey Mouse moment. A moment which captures the imagination of this generation's technologists and creatives alike, something which sets the bar but also the industrial commercial direction of what's to come. I, for one, immediately saw the opportunity to generate entire movies, animation sequences, and visual works without the need for a large team or multi-million dollar blockbuster budget. A decade from now, imagine anyone typing in an advanced movie blockbuster script like Tenet and having AI completely generate many versions of it for you, complete with all the bells and whistles. I'm talking IMAX format, world-class music with full orchestra, highly customized, beautiful computer-generated human actors, and of course, uncannily good, lifelike special effects. Keep in mind, Tenet is no ordinary film to have AI generate for you. At one point in the movie, the main characters literally crash a plane through an airplane hangar, which Christopher Nolan actually filmed in real life. But imagine if AI could generate movies like this for us digitally, sparing us from having to spend $205 million in the real world like Christopher Nolan had to. I'm calling this phenomenon of multimodal AI film and video making Silicon Hollywood. I've even made up a definition. Silicon Hollywood is a new approach to creating industrial quality film and videos where multimodal AI models are used to generate realistic parts of or even entire film or video sequences. And let's be honest here, the writing has been on the wall for something like this for a while now. I'm sure you've seen various deepfake videos as well as all of the advancements we're seeing every day in 3D and animation using AI. But what are the characteristics of Silicon Hollywood? Well, I wrote a whole article in detail exploring this whole Silicon Hollywood idea I have, which I encourage you to check out because this video would otherwise be too long. The defining characteristics that I can imagine include Silicon Hollywood being individualistic or just driven by really small teams. I can also imagine it actually giving creatives the power to develop really abstract concepts they couldn't make before, which could be totally unique moments never before seen in the history of cinema. But definitely the main characteristic of Silicon Hollywood for the first time in film history is that it is likely going to be a lot less driven by production costs, funding, and budget. Special effects or stories which may have costed hundreds of millions of dollars to create in the past may now be achievable with shared access to the same multimodal AI models. Keep in mind, in the past, costs used to drive everything in Hollywood, from costume design, storytelling, location, acting talent pool, and more. This may no longer be the case thanks to multimodal AI. I was surprised to learn the film industry itself has already explored this idea similarly already. In the 2013 film The Congress, an aging actress portrayed by Robin Wright, you probably know her from House of Cards, agrees to preserve her digital likeness for a film studio to exclusively use in films because acting is over. No actor is employed in the future the movie portrays. All acting is done by AI synthesis. In a very psychedelic way, the film explores ideas of celebrity worship culture, humanity's hedonistic love for mindless entertainment, and a mass corporatization of storytelling itself, portraying a future where the worst of the Hollywood industry intersects with the worst of Silicon Valley-like thinking. Finally, in this video, it is worth addressing the economic changes something like Silicon Hollywood could bring. I have friends who work in film. Making a living is already hard for most artists and crew in Hollywood. What does Silicon Hollywood mean for the caterer on site, producer, stunt coordinator, struggling actor? It's sad to think about what it could mean to their livelihoods, their families, the unions they are a part of, and the clients they have built up over the years as freelancers. But I will say this, having spoken to some people in film, many of them fell into the Hollywood industry with the hope of crafting a great film of their own someday. Through multimodal AI, everyone in the film industry may finally be given a chance to craft great multi-million dollar level stories of their own, without the need for approval from the Hollywood elite. So my loose argument is that while Hollywood may currently be providing somewhat of a living for many of these individuals, I would pose the question, do the creatives themselves actually find it fulfilling? Do they feel accomplished and self-actualized by the current status quo in their industry? What great films would they be making if they didn't need the backing of the industry itself? What will they create, and how will they independently profit as brilliant creatives once they are liberated, in a way, through multimodal AI? I apologize if I do not sound compassionate. It's really hard for me to address this issue of employment, but I still think these are important questions to ask, and of course, I sincerely hope for the best for other creatives just like me. The key idea. Silicon Hollywood is a new way of approaching the art of filmmaking. Powered by multimodal AI models, it may completely change Hollywood as we know it.